two motors underneath, put a dog clutch connected to both sides. So if you want to now turn in its own length, you have one foot going forwards, one going backwards. And basically, I stopped one, I put a rubber drive in there so I can make one motor drive against the other. So once they've gone out of sync like that, there's two motors driving through two pulleys.
Yeah.
And this is a little dog clutch. So when you want to steer, the dog clutch will come undone. And then one motor stops. And all you're doing now is starting the other motor up backwards like that. Now, 9 times out of 10, they synchronize themselves here, but put them out in the water and they won't. They just won't, you know. That's why I put in a synchronizer. So when they've got out of sync like this, basically you store one, and then the clutch will just drop back in. There's only a single pin clutch, so you'll always fall back in the same place. And then was a case of playing around with the cranks and the cams.
Didn't you ever get this done? Oh, it's obvious, I can't.
Because,
you know, I mean, I can't imagine how long it must have taken, how many times you must have built bits and put it in the water and taken it out and put it back in again.